Hi everyone, today let us discuss about solar minimum. Okay, this was there in news because space authorities have reported that the sun has gone into a solar minimum state and is about to enter the deepest period of the sunshine recession, or we can say the solar minimum. And it is said that sunspots are not visible at all during this solar minimum, and it has been about 100 days of 2020 when the sun has shown zero sunspot. So it is said that it is about 100 days in 2020 that they are showing no sunspots on the corona of sun. Okay, so this is one of the feature that during this solar minimum, sunspots will not be visible on the sun surface. So this is how we are identifying whether the sun is undergoing which period of its cycle, like whether it is solar minimum or solar maximum. Actually, we have something called solar cycle that we will get into detail later. So in the solar cycle, we have two periods, like solar maximum and solar minimum. During the solar minimum, there will be lesser amount of sunspots. So and maximum, there will be higher number of sunspots. Okay, so first let us see what is sunspot is about. Sunspots are areas that appear dark on the surface of the sun. So they appear dark because they are cooler than the other part of the sun's surface. Okay, and why they are appearing in dark? Okay, that is because in this solar or sunspots areas, they have magnetic field which are very strong in nature. Okay, so when this magnetic field is keeping some heat within the sun from reaching the surface, this is make this particular area cooler compared to other parts of the sun. This is because the sun's magnetic field is strong in this area, and which will keep some of the heat within this area, from reaching out of the surface of sun. Okay, so that is why this is appearing cooler in nature compared to other surface, and it will be appearing in black in color. Okay, so this has black color and is cooler, and here magnetic field is very stronger. Okay, and this number of sunspots will be different compared to the cycle. As I told you earlier, on the solar minimum, there will be no or lesser number of sunspots will be visible, or during the solar maximum, there will be higher number of sunspots are visible. Okay, so now let us see what is solar minimum. That is the topic of discussion. Okay, sun enters solar minimum when a fewer sunspots appear on the star. Okay, marking the end of solar cycle. Every 11 years, sun enters into a new solar circle. So, solar cycle is all about 11 years. It extends about 11 years. So, every 11 years, there will be a new solar cycle. Okay, so this cycle consists of maximum as well as minimum. Solar maximum, there will be high activity. The sun will be very active, and there will be high magnetic field. Strong magnetic field will be available, so hence there will be more sunspot. Okay, whereas in case of solar minimum, the activity will be less, that is why it is called minimum, and the magnetic field will be weak, and there will be lesser amount of sunspots available on the sun. Okay, so all these things are controlled by the sun's magnetic field. Okay, then let us see what is solar cycle and the sun. The sun's magnetic field goes through periodic cycle, as I told you, that is what is called solar cycle, which is the sun's south as well as north pole switches its poles. Okay, there will be a particular point for the south as well as north pole. It is, as I told, it is a magnetic field. So for every magnet, there is a south pole as well as north pole. Okay, so the sun is acting as a magnet, and the sun switches its south and north poles during this magnetic cycle. Okay, so it takes about 11 years for switching its south and north pole, and during the midpoint of the solar cycle, the activity of the sun increases. That is what is the solar maximum. During this time, the events increment in the events of flare ups and sunspots are high. So this period is known as solar maximum, and this is the opposite happens in the solar minimum, where the activities is very low and sunspots as well as solar flares are low. That is why it is called a solar minimum. But this doesn't mean that a sun becomes dull. There is activity going on in the sun, but that is at a minimum level. Okay, and the whole activity in the sun changes in the form. Okay, that is it. There is its form changes in the activity of the sun. Okay, and the overall sun's magnetic field will be weak during this solar minimum. And now the going on solar cycle is 24th, and the next will be 25. And the tentative time period of solar minimum is between April 20 plus or minus 6 months. Okay. And the impact of this solar minimum on Earth is that as the output from the sun is low during this solar minimum, it can result in a little ice age like situation. All these things or all this impact listed here are just assumptions. We are not sure that whether these things will happen or not. These are as per reports, and I have collected all these points from different reports. Okay, so I am not sure whether all these things will happen or not. This all these things are based on experts' opinion. Okay, and second point is that solar minimum may cause freezing temperature, earthquakes, as well as drought, and it is said that it will affect the Earth's magnetic field due to streams of solar wind, and it will change the space weather effects near Earth. And also as it is causing solar wind will be causing disruption to communication and navigation systems. And as it is causing space weather changes during solar minimum, it will affect Earth's upper atmosphere on satellites in low Earth orbits changes. And also we'll be knowing that Earth's temperature is maintained by the temperature from the suns. Okay, so when there is a solar minimum happening in sun, the Earth's upper atmosphere will cool down because it is heated and puffed up by the ultraviolet radiation from the sun. And also the increase in number of galactic cosmic rays that reaches Earth's upper atmosphere. So these are all the impact happens or impact of this solar minimum. So that's all. Thank you.